And here is the Writer's Almanac for Saturday. It's the 16th of October, 2021. It was on this day, 1846, the first successful demonstration of ether anesthesia at Massachusetts General Hospital in Boston. A surgeon named John Collins Warren amputated a tumor from the neck of a patient without him feeling any pain. Ether had often been used for years and years by college students for fun. They gave what they called ether frolics, parties where everybody got high on ether. It's the birthday of Noah Webster, Hartford, Connecticut, 1758, set out to write an American dictionary when he was 43. He wanted Americans to have their own language that wasn't based on the language of England. And also, the dictionary was to help Americans communicate with each other because regional dialects differed so drastically. It was Noah Webster who took the letter U out of English words like color and honor, and he spelled theater and center, E-R, rather than R-E, and introduced American words like squash, wigwam, opossum, presidential, Congress. It's the birthday of Oscar Wilde, born Dublin, 1854, who said all bad poetry springs from genuine feeling. And Eugene O'Neill, born in New York City, 1888. His father was an actor who played the lead in The Count of Monte Cristo more than 6,000 times. O'Neill accompanied him on the road. Eugene O'Neill said, "As a boy, I saw so much of the old ranting, artificial, romantic stage stuff that I always had a sort of contempt for the theater." And then in 1907, when he was 18, he saw Ibsen's Hedda Gabler in New York. And he said, "I discovered an entire new world of the drama, a modern theater where truth might live." Here's a poem for today by Walt Whitman, "Of the Terrible Doubt of Appearances." Of the terrible doubt of appearances, of the uncertainty, after all, that we may be deluded, that maybe reliance and hope are but speculations, after all, that maybe identity beyond the grave is a beautiful fable only, maybe the things I perceive, the animals, plants, men, hills, shining and flowing waters, the skies of day and night, colors, densities, forms, maybe these are, as doubtless they are, only apparitions, and the real something has yet to be known. How often they dart out of themselves as if to confound me and mock me. How often I think neither I know nor any man knows aught of them. Maybe seeming to me what they are, as doubtless they indeed but seem, as from my present point of view, and might prove, as of course they would, naught of what they appear, or naught anyhow, from entirely changed points of view. To me, these and the like of these are curiously answered by my lovers, my dear friends, when he whom I love travels with me or sits a long while holding me by the hand, when the subtle air, the impalpable, and the sense that words and reason hold not surround us and pervade us, then I am charged with untold and untellable wisdom. I am silent. I require nothing further. I cannot answer the question of appearances or that of identity beyond the grave, but I walk or sit indifferent. I am satisfied. He, a hold of my hand, has completely satisfied me." Poem by Walt Whitman, "Of the Terrible Doubt of Appearances." That's the Writer's Almanac for Saturday, October the 16th. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.